Talk TV. I'm your host, Bess Auer of GottaGetBlogging.com.
And I'm Ben Reed from OrlandoWaterhole.com.
So those of you new to our viewership, by the way, I want to welcome Virginia.
Virginia.
We love having you. If you are a blogger or involved with social media, you have found the right place to tune in. So Gotta Get Blogging is a community just for bloggers and social media pros, and Blog Talk TV, basically what it sounds like. We are talking with some of the world's biggest bloggers and social media pros to help bring you some tips and advice and best practices. So thanks everybody for tuning in.
So we like to start all of our shows with what we call the question of the show, an idea to help us think more a little bit about blogging, what we can do better, and some things that we can all learn from. And given that we have some new viewers, Bess, I thought we should start from the very beginning. And I would just like to know, why did you get started in blogging?
Okay, so I was a teacher. Those who know me, I knew I taught for almost 20 years in the classroom, and I taught English. And like most English teachers, I love to read, I love to write, and you know, blogging at its best is just great writing. So it actually started though on July back in 2009, where I wanted to go find where to go see fireworks. So I went online and I knew, you know, the big places, the traditional places, downtown, things like that. But I thought, why do I have to go to 17 different websites to find where to see fireworks in my community? So we actually started the Central Florida Top 5, where we listed the five places to see the fireworks, the five best races coming up, and it kind of spilled into a community blog that allowed me to have a voice to write about my favorite things here. So that was the beginnings, and of course it then went from there to many other things, but how about you?
So I started May of 2007 with an intention of writing to keep in touch with friends and family. So I was traveling on business to South Africa for 5 weeks, and I just wanted to be able to connect with my family, let them know that was what was going on. And it was a lot of fun. People enjoyed reading about the story, so I eventually became a travel blogger and pursued that for a number of years until I wanted to talk a little more about some local things, and so started a podcast that I have today.
So if you want to let us know how you got started with blogging, because really, everybody's new to blogging. Everybody is new to it. Nobody, you know, it was nobody's first job unless you were just right now a teenager or out of college. So let us know what you were doing beforehand and then how it got into it. In fact, today's guest was an attorney before he got into blogging. Mm-hmm. So we'll learn all about that in a little bit.
So you can tweet your answer to the question of the show to @BlogTalkTV. So send us on Twitter, and we'd love to know how you got started and why you got started in blogging.
And speaking of getting started, so I read this this article that lists all these, like the 50 top bloggers in the world, mm-hmm. and their number one tip for new bloggers, what would it be? And the vast majority said, start your email list soon. Start it immediately. Even if you don't think anybody's gonna sign up, start building your email list. And I know how important that is. I know you know how important that is, especially with the declining reach of Facebook. Email goes right to their inbox. So we've got a great video on how to help build your email list. So let's take a look. So growing your email list can be pretty darn challenging. And we've seen all sorts of things, from those annoying pop-ups on blogs to the sign up in the sidebar. But check out this one that I just ran across. So I was looking at an article, Why 10% of the Population Hates Cilantro and the Rest Doesn't Know Any Better. Well, I'm one of those 10%, so that caught my interest anyway. So as I was scrolling down reading all the science behind why I don't like cilantro, I got to the very bottom. Check it out. Once a week, I come up with advice on how to make scientific presentations more awesome. Sign up for the newsletter to get an email with next week's post. And right there is the sign up. Now, I don't do scientific presentations, but this caught my eye. In fact, the article was so good that I read that I actually signed up for this email list. And not only me, Rochelle Lucas, travel blogger, she told me she signed up for it too. So imagine this, at the bottom of every one of your blog posts, you put a sign up. Not a bad idea. Check it out and see how it works.